from the Marshall certificates. So first aim, we combine the optimum binder content of the bitumen. So first we will see what is the Marshall certificate. It is resistant to the plastic deformation of a cylindrical specimen of a bituminous mixture. It is measured when the specimen loaded at the periphery of 5 cm per minute. So it is what is the use of the Marshall certificate? It is used in the designing and evaluating the bituminous paving mixtures. So next we will see what are the objectives of the Marshall stability test. So first objective is the determination of the properties of the mix, and second one is the flow analysis, and last one is the determination of the optimum bitumen content.
Firstly, we will see what is Marshall stability and flow value of the bituminous mix. Marshall stability is the maximum load carried by the compacted specimen at 60 degrees Celsius. And flow value is the deformation at the maximum load carried by the compacted specimen. In this test, main objective is obtain the minimum bitumen content of the bituminous mix for the available aggregates and traffic intensity of the road. Now we will see what are the apparatus required for our practical. This is the Marshall mold of having size 7.5 cm height and 10.6 cm diameter, and this is upper collar and this is base plate, and this is sample excluder, and this is Marshall apparatus, and in this this is breaking head. In this we will feed the Marshall mold, and then this is rammer, and this is compaction pedestal of size 20 by 20 by 45 cm. And this is automatic Marshall apparatus. Okay.
After explaining all the instrument required and the theoretical part, I will explain how to make the mold for the Marshall stability test. First of all, first thing is remember that we have to maintain the 120 degree to 130 degree Celsius of temperature of bituminous mix during the tamping of the all the ingredients. Take the aggregates as per the IRC recommendation and the grading we are designing and taking from the IRC recommendation, and then heat the all the aggregates to 180 degree Celsius to 200 degree Celsius, so that the water content and the moisture in that aggregate and the voids of aggregate, it will remove out. After that, keep aside the all the aggregates and take bitumen and heat it to up to the 140 degree Celsius. Remember that after the 140 degree Celsius temperature, bitumen will take a fire and flash as per the we are tested flash and fire test. Take that bitumen after heating the bitumen up to the 140 degree Celsius temperature. Wet that heated liquid bitumen as per the percentage of bitumen taken of the weight of aggregate. Suppose we have to take 5% of bitumen of the total weight of aggregate. Our total weight of aggregate is 1200 gram. So 5% means the 60 gram of bitumen we have to take and mix it with the aggregate. So and mix total mix mixing temperature of the bitumen mix is 160 degree Celsius. Why 160 degree Celsius temperature we have to maintain during the mixing? Because during the tamping, during mixing to the tamping, we have to take a lot of time, and so that it will decrease. It will decrease the temperature. So that if we maintain the mixing temperature 160 degree Celsius, then only we get 120 to 130 degree Celsius temperature during the tamping. After mixing the all the bituminous mix at 160 degree Celsius, take that heated bituminous mix and carry it to the towards the mold. Fill the mold in 3 layers of with 25 numbers of short blows, and then tamp it with the hammer as per instruction in IRC 75 numbers of blows in each side, so that we have to tamp with both sides.
Now
I'm going to explain about the gradation. Gradation of aggregate is an important factor which is affected on a permanent formation of hot mix bitumen and aggregate. The bitumen content which can be tested in accordance with the IS-2386 part 3 and combined gradation range of the different size of aggregate which can be tested for IRC-111. The given table shows the gradation of aggregate as per IS-111. Here the sieve sizes and minimum component ranges. We find the percentage passing. We take the average of these ranges to get the percentage passing, and we calculate the cumulative percentage retained. We subtract the percentage passing from 100. Then we calculate the weight of retained aggregate. Using this cumulative percentage retained, we got the weight of retained aggregate as per sample calculation. Total of this weight of retained aggregate 1200 multiplied by the percentage of cumulative retained, we got the 60 grams. As per sample calculation, 1200 is the total weight of retained aggregate. By the 5% of percentage retained, we got the 60 grams of aggregate on a particular sieve.
Heated the aggregate to make a mold and measure the temperature of this aggregate by using this automatic thermometer. We have to maintain the temperature of the aggregate about 180 to 200 degrees Celsius. Here we heat the bitumen at 140 degrees Celsius to make a mold. After heating the bitumen at 140 degrees Celsius, 4.5% of the bitumen it will be added in total weight of the aggregate, which is a 1200 gram, and we add the 4.5% of bitumen, that is 60 gram of bitumen.
Just a little bit. Just
after adding the bitumen and all the aggregate, we mix the this mixture to make a uniform mixture of aggregate and bitumen to make a mold at a 160 degrees Celsius. Bitumen and aggregate at 160 degrees Celsius, we add it in a mold to make a mold, and temperature at 120 degrees Celsius to make a mold. After filling the material in three different layers by tamping the short rod, and we use a 75 number of gloves both the sides.
काय झालं नीट बसलाय का तो
75 नंबर ऑफ ब्लोस टू द अनदर साइड ऑफ द मोल्ड. रिमूव द मोल्ड बाय हायड्रॉलिक एक्सक्लूडर
So now we will see how to test the mold. So this is the mold we have prepared. So we have to put it in water bath so that it will gain the critical temperature. So why we put it critical temperature? So it will sustain for below the critical temperature. So now we will put this block it into the water bath for 1 hour at the temperature of 60 degrees. So now the our mold is ready. So now we can test the mold. So we will test the mold on the Marshall apparatus.
This is the mold which we had prepared. Now after making the mold, which we agitated at 60 degrees Celsius. Now we are testing on Marshall machine. This is the deflectometer on which we can measure the flow of the bitumen sample. And this is the automatic stability measurer device. In this, it is digital and it directly shows the load which are carried by this mold. Now we are testing this mold. Here we adjust the assembly by this metal ball by using this button. First we applying all the initial setting. We are giving load to the specimen.
After testing, remove the mold.
So now this is the tested mold. So look how it
looks like.
So these are the results of stability and flow, which are obtained from the tested molds. So we plot the graph of percentage of bitumen versus the stability and percentage of bitumen versus flow. So these graphs we can calculate actually the percentage of bitumen which are required for our pavement design. So from the Marshall stability test we can determine the Marshall stability flow analysis and finally the bitumen content of the bitumen.